My name is Lyndsay Baker. I am a graduate of DMACC, of the Biotechnology Program. I graduated in May of 2017.
Lyndsay is awesome as a student in my program. She's graduated now and I miss her.
You know how we all have the big starry-eyed dream. Mine has always been to do something with NASA. And actually, that's how I came upon this, was through DMACC. There's a program of NASA's called the National Community College Aerospace Scholars Program. I discovered the program. I applied for the program, got in, went down to Huntsville for about 4 days, and that was in the fall of 16.
Because of that experience, she's very driven and excited about STEM and really loves working with NASA and everything that they do. And so when she got this opportunity to apply, submit a proposal for her idea of what to send into space, she was just overjoyed.
The project I'm currently working on right now with NASA, we're going to send algae to space. So I am growing space algae right now. The algae we're growing, it's called Hematococcus pluvialis. What this particular algae does, the reason it's rather important is it produces a antioxidant carotenoid called astaxanthin, and it will produce that upon a state of agitation.
So the pH changes, the salt concentrations change, because the puddle's drying out, or the temperatures are changing, or the light is too intense. All of those things will normally stress out the algae. And to survive, you know, their puddle potentially drying for a while, they form a tough casing around their outside, and it's called a spore, and that keeps them alive. And internally, to protect themselves from damage, they produce this antioxidant.
What the hypothesis is that sending this to space, that the effects of microgravity on the algae will be enough to agitate it. And one reason we think that is the algae, they are gravitonic, which means for single-celled little algae, they can actually tell up from down. So it could be a food source in space. It's a photosynthetic plant, so it could provide oxygen. And then having that ready source of astaxanthin on station for eyes and bone health would be huge, because those are two big concerns with deep space travel. Right now, the project, we're going to launch in November. We're slated to launch on November 16th through SpaceX. So it's a project with NASA and SpaceX. So it's very exciting. Absolutely very exciting.